New at 11, wildlife, a hot issue right now on the Monterey Peninsula as people who live in Pacific Grove say they're seeing a lot more raccoons than usual. Some wonder if it's the drought or could it be that PG has just been a long-time raccoon hangout and we're just seeing more of them. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen has more tonight live from our Salinas newsroom.
Well, Dan, that's a question tonight, and it's one we can't quite answer yet. Statistics don't show animal control calls on the rise, but neighbors say they're seeing them everywhere.
You can hear them walking on the roof of the carport, so, you know, I see them all the time.
Raccoons all over Pacific Grove.
I mean, I see them at night a lot when we're driving home. There's huge families of them. They zip into the sewer drains and then they watch you as you drive by. You can see their eyes.
Whether there are more of the masked animal watching you and moving into town is up for debate.
I'm not sure if there's more or not.
But it's a legitimate concern.
It's really scary when you have a little one because there's fecal matter that can get in your yard and they're aggressive towards your pets. It's not very healthy.
This is video from 1998 when a Pacific Grove child suffered serious brain damage after ingesting raccoon feces infected with raccoon roundworm in his family's yard.
Probably a piece of feces about this size, something like this, only about that size, would be more than enough if it were infective to infect a child.
Other parts of California are seeing animals like bobcats, mountain lions, and deer moving closer to urban areas looking for water during this drought. And that's a possibility with these guys.
They always seem to be around a water site. So these guys are very frequently will go into koi ponds or bird baths. They like to play in the water. Dog bowls that have water, they like to play in those too. They're curious. They like to play in the water, and they also like to dip their food in the water as well. We haven't seen any increase in volume of calls.
And while that official number hasn't gone up yet, they say there are a number of things you can do to make your home less inviting for raccoons. You can keep a porch light and the radio on because, of course, they like to come out at night. They don't like the light. You can trim your hedges so they don't have a place to hide. Don't leave your pet food out because they say that's just like a buffet for raccoons. And you can set out towels soaked in ammonia because they hate the smell. And, of course, make sure that raccoons can't break into your garbage cans. Dan.
All right. Thanks very much. Appreciate it, Brittany. California Department of Fish and Wildlife says you should check out their campaign. It's called Keep Me Wild, teaching homeowners the advantage of implementing those tips and keeping animals wild.